Good morning, Downriver. Welcome today. Happy Father's Day to all the fathers out there. I'd just like to let you know that my name is Bill Curtis, and I'll be opening with some of our announcements today. We also have a guest speaker today. As if you missed last week, Pastor Bob, we had a great celebration for him as he retired. So he is moving on to bigger and better things. So today, we have Reverend Chris Hooten today. He is a children's director at the Church of the Holy Redeemer in Rochester Hills. So he will be delivering today's message. So welcome, Chris. Thank you. If this is your first time here, I'd like to invite you to check in the back with a Connect card, fill out your name and your email address, phone number, address, some contact information so we can keep you informed of what's happening here at Downriver. You'll also see what's happening today through the bulletin that you might have received as you walked into the worship space that has a lot of the upcoming events that are going on here at Downriver. On the back of the Connect card is a place for your prayer requests. If you have a prayer request, please stop at the back table if you're in the room. I also want to welcome those online. You can also submit a prayer request through our 24/7 prayer room. Look on our website and you can find access to that. We have a number of ways to give too at our church. Our church is very giving. We have our food pantries on Thursdays. We also have a community garden that we've started. We can't wait for that to start producing vegetables that we'll be able to pass out to the community. You can also give us a check or money into your tithing envelope or into an envelope in the back. You just put it in the basket. If you're not here and you want to send in some money, please send it to the address here at 14400 Beach Daily Road. We use these gifts to reach out to the community and to do the Lord's work. Today, Linda Conger will be delivering our call to worship. Thank you, Linda. Welcome, everyone.
Welcome. This morning's call to worship was written by Joanna Herriter and posted on Spacious Faith. As Abraham welcomed the strangers, so God welcomes us. God greets us with joy and says, "Rest here for a while." God brings out water to wash our dusty feet. God prepares a meal to nourish our weary spirits. So let us receive the gracious hospitality of our God. Let us rest in this holy place where there's shade and water and food and laughter. Whether you are worshiping at home or in this place, please stand as you are able and join in singing "Forever and Holy is the Lord."
Above all things, his love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise. With a mighty hand and an outstretched arm, his love endures forever. For the life that's been reborn, his love endures forever. Forever God is strong. to the setting sun. His love endures forever, and by the grace of God, we will carry on. His love endures forever.
Rising up all around, it's the end.
sing. Everyone sing. Holy is the Lord God Almighty. The earth is filled with His glory. Holy is the Lord.
Morning's first scripture passage is from Genesis chapter 18, verses 1 through 15, from the New Revised Standard Version. The Lord appeared to Abraham by the oaks of Mamre as he sat at the entrance of his tent in the heat of the day. He looked up and saw three men standing near him. When he saw them, he ran from the tent's entrance to meet them and bowed down to the ground. He said, "My Lord, I find favor with you. Do not pass your servant. Let a little water be brought and wash your feet and rest yourselves under the tree. Let me bring a little bread that you may refresh yourselves, and after that you may pass on, since you have come to your servant." So they said, "Do as you have said." And Abraham hastened into the tent to Sarah and said, "Make quickly three measures of choice flour, knead it, and make cakes." Abraham ran to the herd and took a calf, tender and good, gave it to the servant who hastened to prepare it. Then he took curds and milk and the calf that he had prepared and set it before them, and he stood by them under the tree while they ate. They said to him, "Where is your wife Sarah?" He said, "There, in the tent." Then one said, "I will surely return to you in due season, and your wife Sarah shall have a son." And Sarah was listening at the tent entrance behind him. Now Abraham and Sarah were old, advanced in age. It had ceased to be with Sarah after the manner of women. So Sarah laughed to herself, saying, "After I have grown old and my husband is old, shall I be fruitful?" The Lord said to Abraham, "Why did Sarah laugh and say, 'Shall I indeed bear a child now that I am old?' Is anything too wonderful for the Lord? At the set time, I will return to you, and in due season, and Sarah shall have a son." But Sarah denied, saying, "I didn't laugh," for she was afraid. He said, "Yes, you did laugh." I would laugh too. The second scripture passage is from Genesis chapter 21, verses 1 through 7, also from the New Revised Standard Version. The Lord dealt with Sarah as he had said, and the Lord did for Sarah as he had promised. Sarah conceived and bore Abraham a son in his old age, at the time of which God had spoken to him. Abraham gave the name Isaac to his son whom Sarah bore him. And Abraham circumcised his son Isaac when he was 8 days old, as God had commanded him. Abraham was 100 years old when his son Isaac was born to him. Now Sarah said, "God has brought laughter for me. Everyone who hears will laugh with me." And she said, Who would ever have said to Abraham that Sarah would nurse children? Yet I have borne him a son in his old age.
Abraham sat by the door of his tent in the shade of the oaks of Mamre. His mind was lost in pleasant thoughts. Reveries filled his head with puns and whimsies. Where does a sheep go to get its wool cut, he thought. The baba shop. That's a good one. What does one nut say to the other when they're playing tag? I'm a cashew. Did you hear the rumor about butter? No? I'm not going to spread it. Then his mind went back to the biggest laugh he had ever had. One night, he was out in the desert by his tent, talking with God. He was 99 years old at the time. And God showed up. And he said to him, I am the strong God. Live entirely before me. Live to the hilt. I'll make a covenant between us, and I'll give you a huge family. Overwhelmed, Abram fell flat on his face. And then God said to him, this is my covenant with you. You'll be the father of many nations. Your name will no longer be Abram, but Abraham, meaning that I'm making you the father of many nations. I'll make you a father of fathers. I'll make you nations from you. Kings will issue from you. I will establish my covenant between me and you, a covenant that includes your descendants, a covenant that goes on and on and on, a covenant that commits me to be your God and the God of your descendants. And I'm giving you and your descendants this land where now you're just camping, this whole country of Canaan, to own forever. And I'll be their God. God continued speaking to Abraham. And Sarai, your wife, don't call her Sarai anymore. Call her Sarah. I'll bless her. Yes, I'll give you a son by her. Oh, how I'll bless her. Nations will come from her. Kings of nations will come from her. Abraham fell flat on his face and he laughed, thinking, can a 100-year-old man father a son? And can Sarah at 90 years have a baby? Hey, he thought, if I'm going to be the father of a great nation, I better get started on the dad jokes. A bear comes into my tent and he says, Abraham, I'm hungry. And Abraham say, hi, hungry, but why the great paws? And he says, I don't know, I was just born with them. And then Abraham looks up and he sees through the waves of heat rising off of the road, three men coming near. I wonder if he recognized them from the other night, or if it was just the fact that it was the hottest part of the day and travelers were coming by that he jumped up from his seat. He ran from his tent to greet them, and he bowed before them, and he said, Master, if it please you, stop for a while with your servant. I'll get water so you can wash your feet. Rest under this tree, and I'll get some food to refresh you on your way, since your travels have brought you across my path. And they said, certainly, go. Go ahead. I wonder though, what was the biggest laugh in your life? Where did it come from? Well, Abraham hurried into the tent to Sarah, and he said, "Hurry, get 3 cups of our best flour, knead it, and make bread." Well, Sarah began kneading the dough, and the work of her hands freed her mind to think. There was sorrow that surfaced when she was alone with her thoughts. So many years she was filled with longing. So long that the dull ache had lost its meaning. And the emptiness just sat there like the maw of an abyss. She knew of Abraham's dreams for a big family. She had dreamed too, since she was a little girl. The pace of the kneading increased as she poured into the loaves her feelings. Her dreams had shriveled, and now they were as dry and dusty as her womb. She thought of all the ways that they had tried. They tried to make it a reality, but it failed. They brought along their nephew Lot, but he separated from them. There was a steward, Eleazar, but he was a servant, not family, not an heir. And now it had been over 13 years since she gave her handmaid Hagar to Abraham, thinking that she could have a family through her. Sarah had been cut out of that relationship and bitterly regretted it. Ah, well, she sighed, putting the bitterness back into its bottle for another time. She threw the loaves onto the hot stone. There was a joy that came in receiving visitors. Abraham and Sarah had always pitched their tent in the busy roads and the routes so that they could welcome strangers that passed by. She had great excitement, lavishing weary travelers with prodigal hospitality. Even next to the abyss of her soul, there was a fount that would hilariously give to those passing by. Abraham, too, when he had left Sarah, he had other things to prepare. Then Abraham ran to the cattle pen and picked out a nice plump calf and gave it to the servant, who had lost no time in getting it ready. He then got curds and milk and brought them with the calf that had been roasted. And he set the meal before the men and stood there under the tree while they ate. I wonder if you felt like Sarah, with dreams that seem to dry and wither on the vine. I also wonder if this feast reminds you of other feasts in Scripture. Here we see Abraham and Sarah acting like God, acting from the heart of God. Can you see a prodigal father? Or the communion table? Ah, but who were these road-weary visitors? The scripture says that God showed up. Were these angels? The pre-incarnate Christ with messengers of flame? One Christian contemplating this, Andrei Rublev, back in the early 1400s, painted this. He imagines the threefold God visiting Abraham. We see on the left in front of Abraham's house, the Father, the creator of the world. On the right here, clothed in green of growth, we see the spirits who hovered over the water and nurtured creation. And in the center, the Son, the giver of life in so many ways, who would always act as host and break the bread at any meal that he was at. There under the oak of Mamre, under the tree of life, stands in for the cross. And what do we know about this beautiful being represented at this table? God has always been. Now think of the beginning of the universe, stretching back so long that our minds can't even begin to understand and to get a grasp around it. And God was there for an infinity before that. And we wonder, what were these at the table doing all that time? They were enjoying themselves. I mean, look at the way their heads are bowed to each other in admiration of each other. They spent eternity adoring each other in the hidden life of the Trinity that we can't even begin to understand. But we'll have an eternity to try. Here we have the most joyful being in the universe and beyond. Out of the fullness of joy, God created all that we see and sustains all things. Now, can you imagine entertaining God at your house? Watching God eat your food, enjoying the food and reveling with you. See, here we have a clue as to what's going to happen in Abraham and Sarah's story, in the nature of who God is. So the men said to Abraham, "Where is Sarah, your wife?" He said, "In the tent." One of them said, "I'm coming back about this time next year. When I arrive, your wife Sarah will have a son." Sarah was listening in the tent opening just behind the man. Abraham and Sarah were old by this time, very old. Sarah was far past the age of having babies. And Sarah laughed within herself. "An old woman like me get pregnant with this old man as a husband?" What kind of laugh do you imagine? I don't think it was a scoffing laugh out of bitterness. I think it was an incredulous one out of just something that was too fantastic, too wonderful for words. It's a surprise that brings laughter. And God said to Abraham, "Why did Sarah laugh? Saying, 'Me have a baby? An old woman like me? Is anything too hard for God? I'll be back about this time next year, and Sarah will have a baby.'" Sarah lied. She said, "I didn't laugh," because she was afraid. She didn't want to offend, but he said, "Yes, you did. You laughed." And here is the gospel. God enters our world of darkness and pain. God, overflowing with joy, and he brings joy. And we laugh with God. So God visited Sarah exactly as he said he would. God did to Sarah what he promised. And Sarah became pregnant and gave Abraham a son in his old age. And at that very time, God had said, Abraham named him Isaac when his son was just 8 days old. Abraham circumcised him just as God had commanded. Abraham was 100 years old when he had his son Isaac. And Sarah said, "God has blessed me with laughter, and all who get the news will laugh with me. And she also said, whoever would have suggested to Abraham that Sarah would one day nurse a baby? Yet here I am. I've given the old man a son. God fulfills God's purpose. The promise is kept. The kingdom of God breaks open into our world. And all who see it laugh. They'll laugh with us. Let's pray. To fulfill the ancient promise of salvation, O God, you made a covenant with our ancestors and pledged them descendants more numerous than the stars. Grant that all the people may share in the blessing of your covenant, accomplished through the death and resurrection of your Son, and sealed by the gift of your Spirit. Amen. Now, gathering our prayer and our praise into one, let us together pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you, Chris. Now, as you are able, please stand and join us in our last song.
Running after, it's running after.
God of the prophets and apostles, you greeted old Abraham and Sarah with news of wonder and life. Send us into the world to preach good news as Jesus did. Heal the sick, resist evil, and bring the outcast home. Amen. Blessings on you.